Hey guys, Mary Jam. So June 24th at 9:39. So I finally am doing videos. So basically, when I woke up, I pretty much just put away the dishes and then started prepping some food. And even though I'm not done it, I wanted to do this area. So Bud always hides behind the TV there. There's a lot of cables back there, so I'm always worried that he'll get tangled in one of them. So I'm gonna move this, and I'm gonna move this stuff, and I'm gonna try to get behind there. We'll see if I move everything out of the way. I might have to unhook some things. So, and actually, the CD player and the DVD player, they don't really work for some reason. So I might just unplug them and put them aside somewhere because I never use them anyways. I always have my YouTube on, so I could get stuff done. So just like my cooking videos, I'm gonna have my playlist in the background, and I think I'm gonna keep my Christian music on. And Bud actually ran into the other room. I can't find him, so I'm like, this is a perfect time to do it right now because he's not over here and it won't scare him with the noise. I feel kind of bad for walking him off in his hiding spot, but none of the cats that I've had ever hid behind the spot. So that's why I want to clear it. So then that way, if I ever have to take him to the vet, I don't have to worry about him getting in there. It's just like the couch. Before the couch, I used to have it this way. Straight, like, bad at which way. So now I have it sideways, but before I just moved it to the wall, so then that way Hope couldn't hide behind the couch. So I forgot to do that when Bud came, so that's why I'm probably doing it now. So I'm gonna be moving stuff around, and hopefully then he won't hide there anymore. But he'll still be in the living room. Oh, there's Bud. So we're gonna give him some treats first. You guys can see Bud. So, I just don't want to scare him. But I'm not vacuuming, I'm just moving the stuff and I'm plugging everything. Is that better? Yeah. Oops. Yeah, so the bed's under there, so I'm gonna give him some treats first. Let's see here. Bud! Want treats? There you go. Okay. Never had any treats yet? That's my boy. That's so funny how I have had five cats and none of them hid behind the spot. So I already told family. So yeah, I'll see what I can move and what I can't. I'm not going to try to move the TV, obviously. It's just the other spots. But I wanted you guys to see Bud. He's still doing better. Like I said, he pretty much hides behind there during the day and then he's out at night. And I just washed the blankets, so that's why I didn't do any videos beforehand, because of like I didn't wake up till like 2 o'clock, and then all of a sudden it was 5. Like I gotta do laundry, and then I took family's kids to the park, so I took photos of me at the park and I put them in the community tab. And then I was gonna continue cooking, but then I'm like, I'm worried that Bud's gonna get into the cables and get tangled or something, especially how long he is, as you could see. So I'm gonna try and move that stuff around for him. So hopefully then he won't hide behind there anymore too. That's the other thing, is that I don't want him hiding there because I can't get to it. But I'm gonna wait till Bud finishes the treats so I don't scare him. That's my boy. Hey, Bud. Still a little scared, so like I said, again, he's been through a lot. I've been also watching a lot of YouTube videos about scared cats, and they say that too. They said cats, when they've been through a lot, you gotta give them time to adjust, bribe them with treats and food, which I've already been doing. So I find it kind of funny because I've been watching all these videos and I'm like, it's pretty much everything I already know that I've learned, but I always like to get a second perspective from other people. So, and there's always stuff you could learn about cats. Like, yeah, sure, I've had five cats. I've worked at Tesla, I've worked at PetSmart, but you can never stop learning new things. And I've never, ever, ever had a cat scared of me before. So, Bud's, well, he's not scared of me, he's scared of So, again, don't take it personally if you guys get a cat and he's scared of you. He's not scared of you, he's scared of the situation. A lot, like I said, I don't know much about the history for his old owners, but I know that they were not looking after him properly. So he's using the litter box right now. So yeah, you just have to. So that's the one thing that they keep saying in the videos, is that you just have to be mindful that don't take it personally. It's just that it's not you, it's the situation that he's in, because he's moved around so many times. Get the litter box. I'm hoping, I want him to use the pallet litter, but I don't want to force it on him. So I have three different litter boxes, which, like I was telling you guys, so I have the clay litter in one, and another one, the other one, and then I have the pallets in the green one. He's actually used the pallet ones, but not as much as the other ones. So, but we're not gonna vacuum or anything, because it's still too soon. I don't want to freak him out as it already is. But if you guys could see, I have a lot of electronics here, so I'm gonna have to figure that out. I have my DVD player there. I have my CD player, so I was thinking of moving this stuff here and moving that and putting that to the side, because I never use them anyways. I don't really know if I want to keep them or not, because like I said, I have a CD player. So, and I find that this is actually too loud when I use a CD player. So yeah, I'll find out if family, because that's who I got it from, if they want it. And then I could put my DVD player there, and then I could move this. This doesn't have to be there. So I'm kind of changing things around. So yeah, I'll see if they want it. But I know the TELUS thing is hooked up here, so I don't quite know how to do that yet. It has to be on something, I know that. But yeah, I just basically want to get rid of the CD players, because I'm like, I never use them, so what's the point of it having it here? It's just to have this dresser here. It's kind of just here, because those things are taking up space. So I'm also going to be getting rid of these. Maybe I could sell them. I don't know, they're pretty old. They're really, really old, so I'm just waiting until Bud's done so we could move the stuff so they take the CDs out. Actually, I'll do that now. So, in a way, it's kind of good though that I have a cat now, because now I'm getting rid of, like I said, ever since my cat's passed away, I've been trying to get rid of stuff. And now I'm trying to get rid of more stuff. There goes Bud. Hey, Bud. He still hasn't slept on the bed yet, but he's come up on the bed. So, I don't know what AF means on my phone, but apparently I locked it. But it's still recording, so I don't want to stop and then record it. So we're gonna, oops, move stuff around. But first I'm gonna turn on my CD player and take out the CDs. So I have these. Because yeah, for some reason it turns on, but when I try to turn the volume on, it doesn't play or anything, just the radio and other stuff. So it's like, okay. Maybe we'll play, we gotta play this at some point in my CD player. And I've been playing, I have a whole playlist now for Cat TV that I've been playing for Bud, so if you guys want that, or my Christian music playlist, it's under my playlist. So, Mom's Mix. And some 41 CD. But like I said, I have not used this in many, many years because I use YouTube for music. I still have CDs. But like I said, when I have my, what's the thing called? Computer on. Oh boy, he stunk up the place. When he has the computer on. Then I use my stereo, like, when I'm cleaning in the other room, so, yeah, I gotta clean that litter box. It stinks. He stinks up the whole place. I don't think you guys want to watch me do the cat litter, so I'm gonna put the music on. And then, there's Bud. Hey, Bud. He's so cute. I hope it doesn't scare him though. Oh, Bud, you stink. He just is such a stinky boy. Such a stinky boy. So now whenever I do, that's the reason why I have the cat litter in that room. Because it's close to where I sleep. So whenever I smell it, I'm like, I gotta do the litter, man. But boy, does he ever stink. Hey, Bud. So I'll probably scare him and I'll probably start running in the other room when I start moving things around. So, I'll put the music on. And then at 32 minutes, I'll stop and then go for a smoke and then do another one. And then later, we'll go through the files. That I still want to do because I still want to read what they have to say for when you get a new cat because I haven't. I have to send them an email too. So yeah, if you don't want the noise, turn down the volume. Oh, look at Bud. he's in the tent. There. Oh. And he goes back underneath the table. So I also got my food and my coffee here. I'm just eating my leftover noodles. So if you don't want the noise on, but he's probably gonna run when they start moving stuff around. I kinda really don't wanna do it when he's here in this room, but I don't wanna put it off because tomorrow I'm busy, so and I'm worried that he's gonna get tangled in the water. So turn down the music if you don't wanna hear the Christian. He's like, and there's the laundry done. Oops. I'll have you guys watch Bud when I do the litter. Yeah. There's a huge mess behind here too. Probably can't see it.
Oh.
It's like, what are you doing to my spot? I'm trying to figure out these cables. I'm just gonna start unplugging everything up with this. These two. Okay. It's so cute. Look at his face. What are you doing? What are you doing? Sorry, bud, you could go to the other room. Well, he's not running away, at least he's just on the table. Your butt's so confused. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.